Half-Life. It's a game that's often quoted as easily one of the best FPS games ever made. If you've never played it, shame on you. I'm joking, of course. About the shame part, that is. I've always enjoyed the game, and although it's aged slightly, it's still really enjoyable and one that should definitely be part of your gaming library. So as is my norm, I'm going to start with the story. I won't reveal too much because the game is fairly lengthy and the story plays a major role in the game, especially about a third of the way in. You play as a scientist named Gordon Freeman, who, in the intro, is just on the tram to the sector he works in. It's a fairly long intro, and everything is done in the first person. So as the credits are rolling and the tram works its way down the Black Mesa rail system, you can freely move around and look into your surroundings to get a feel to what's happening down here. I still think this is probably one of the longest intros I've ever seen, at least in an FPS game. I could be wrong, though. In any case, Gordon gets off on his stop, a security guard lets him through the door, and Gordon has to walk around the lab, first finding his hazard suit and then moving to the actual work area. From here, two scientists assist him with some sort of experiment. Then, of course, it goes horribly wrong, causing a huge reaction and introducing some sort of alien creatures to the lab. Now you have to get out and survive. Eventually, Gordon is told that he needs to launch an emergency satellite to call for help, but from here, things are going downhill real quickly, with the addition of stronger creatures and even human mercenaries. Gordon himself is silent, of course. So all of this story is given to you as you're playing by interacting with scientists, security, and just listening for radio chatter. So if you're one of those people who don't really pay attention to stuff in-game, expecting to be able to just read the story somewhere else, well, you still can, but that's no fun. You really want to use the speakers or headphones to be fully immersed in the atmosphere Half-Life brings. As far as gameplay goes, it's your standard FPS game, at least for the most part. Gordon has a numeric health and armor system, the armor being his hazard suit power level. As long as you have some power remaining, it'll absorb the majority of any damage that Gordon takes, especially if it's environmental, like radiation or electrical. The health and armor are replenished in multiple ways. You can find your standard health packs or power pickups. There are wall-mounted medical and power stations that you can use to heal up and don't need to be used in full, so you can use part of them and then come back later. They do have a finite charge, though. And finally, in later parts of the game, you can find healing pools or things that look like standing teleporters. Each of these slowly regenerates Gordon's health, but don't do anything for the hazard suit. There's plenty of weapons to be found, from the pistol that he gets on early, to the M16 or MP5, depending on what version of the game you have, to even some alien weapons like the one that has infinite ammo and shoots harmful insects that can either be rapid-fired in a straight line, or slower but try to home in on your enemies. There's some experimental ones as well, such as the ones that resemble a railgun that completely obliterates your enemies in seconds. But most remember the first weapon you obtain in the game, as it seems to be the staple of the series, a crowbar. I don't understand why everyone remembers a crowbar over everything else in the game, but it really stuck. You'll be using it frequently enough early in the game, and also later when you don't feel like wasting any ammo and want to take out headcrabs or simple boxes to see what's inside. I will say that the explosives of the game have any sort of trajectory are done weakly. Grenades are lobbed haphazardly, and it's hard to get them to go where you want. As for the underbarrel grenade launcher or the MP5 or M16, again depending on what version of the game you have, they just don't fire as far as you'd expect. I've fired these in real life. If you have the arc right, these things have an amazing potential distance. But in Half-Life, it's like a little fairy is just pushing the grenade out of the barrel. That's how weak it is. It's not quite as bad as Benon Soldier's grenade launcher, but it's still pretty pathetic. There is another part of the game that defines itself a bit more than your standard shooter. There's some decent puzzles that need to be completed in order to progress. Some of them are as simple as pushing boxes around so that you can reach a previously out of reach area, but others require a bit more thought, like a warehouse later in the game where the trip mines lead all over, and if you touch one, it's an instant game over. So you'll have to duck through and jump over them, and when you get to a switch to give you one final platform to jump from, you'll see that there's a box on it that will break a beam and boom goes the dynamite. Hope you saved. Speaking of saving, you'll want to quick save a lot. The game is relentless, and after every major battle or tricky chasm crossed, you'll want to press F6 to quick save. Yeah, F6. I ended up changing it to the standard F5, but F6 is the default quick save option, and F7 is a quick load. You can probably guess that I've accidentally loaded instead of saved multiple times. But back to the saving frequently piece I just mentioned. You probably won't worry about it early on, but once you get zapped around a bit and enter the opposing dimension, you'll see that there's a bunch of floating platforms, and you can guess that it's going to get tricky pretty quickly. So yeah, you leap, you save, repeat. I may as well mention that there is platforming that you'll have to do. Although it's mostly seen in the final parts of the game, you will have to do some calculated jumping throughout the entire game. The movement of the game is fairly loose, so these jumps are definitely going to take some practice. I really don't understand why people think an FPS game needs jumping sections, but hey, they're in Half-Life and you'll just have to deal with them. But in addition to the standard jumping, you'll have to get used to what's called crouch jumping. Basically, when you jump, you can press crouch a millisecond later to, I guess, pull up Gordon's legs, allowing him to reach platforms that are out of his jumping span by an inch. Does it make sense? Not really, but it's something you need to use. It's just awkward to have to hit space to jump and then control to crouch, and I can't understand why you just jump to areas that you're supposed to get to. Just to frustrate me, I assume. Of course, the game isn't perfect. I'm gonna duck now, because I know there's gonna be plenty of fanboys that are digitally throwing shit at me, getting ready to type out some hate mail, and leave Call of Duty raging player-style comments. But hear me out. I'm just gonna talk about some of the glitches and quirks I encounter when playing the game. I'll start with the biggest quirk, the echoing sound effects. Sometimes these make sense, like when you're in the labs in larger rooms. But sometimes when you're outside and your feet are on gravel, you still echo, even when choosing weapons. I really think it's a matter of the game not loading the sound filter properly, because sometimes if I die and reload, it fixes itself. But I wanted to mention it regardless. But now the glitches, and I'll just rattle them off a bit quickly instead of dwelling on each one, because it's really unnecessary other than the one I will spend some time on. So let's see. I got stuck in the ground when leaping down from a hill. Required a reload. The crossbow trajectory underwater was a bit higher than it should be, making aiming it at the alien fish a real chore. Fix for that? Fire more arrows and hope at least a few of them hit. Some sound effects or music tracks just failed to load, denoted by the constant messages at the top left of the screen. I noticed this the most with the Abbott and Costello messages. I would really like to know what Abbott and Costello have to do with Half-Life, though. The friendly AI can be frustrating, because if you tell them to follow you, they may start out in your tracks, but then when you turn around, you'll find that they just stopped without telling you. This is when I wish I could just pick up the bastards and bring them where I wanted them to be, because the whole point of them following you is to unlock a door that you don't have access codes for. The biggest glitch, though, is in the stage powered up. You're getting chased by a hulking, armored creature that basically has flamethrowers for hands. You need to turn on some power so that you can lure the creature to the electrical room and fry it, at the same time giving the motorized lift some use, which you'll use a lot in the next stage. But when I turn on the power, the metal gate that was supposed to open never opened. I ran around the stage multiple times, thinking maybe I missed something. But nope. Looked up multiple walkthroughs, which I never had to do the many times I've played the game before, and from what I read, I wasn't missing anything. So I had to set Half-Life up in developer mode just to enable noclip so I can get through the gate. As for the creature, I found you can actually just kill it with explosives, so 10 grenades and about 3 M203 grenades later, it went boom. I just don't get it. Another thing I don't understand, although it's not a glitch, is why the enemy mercs sound like robots. The scientists and security guards sound fine, but there's something weird about the mercs. Are they the Combined Forces from Half-Life 2? I don't know, but it just sounds off. But maybe it's supposed to be that way. I don't know. There isn't much music to the game, but what there is mainly techno in nature, trying to bump up the adrenaline level. Most of the music occurs in high-stress areas, normally when you're being chased by something. It works. As for the graphics, sure, they look a bit dated at times, but overall, there's definitely no complaints. Okay, I lied. There is one complaint I have. When you enter the alien world, everything just feels so bare. I just feel like a bit more effort could have went into this part of the game, especially after the level of detail that went into Black Mesa and the Lambda Labs. And I think that's all I have for Half-Life. Yes, it's a bit glitchy. Yes, the visual quality fades in the later parts of the game. Yes, the game's challenge level varies. Yes, those damn jumping areas are best forgotten. But yes, this game is fun as hell. If you like FPS games, you must play this. It really is as much of a staple of the genre as games like Doom, Quake, and Duke Nukem 3D. Final score? 8 out of 10. This is Reaper. Happy fragging.